today I want to focus on the business of the Australian Labor Party. And today I want to focus on the future reform of the Australian Labor Party. The Labor Party I intend to lead will be a modern Labor Party. I want a more democratic Labor Party. I want one which is more representative of the face of modern Australia. And I want a Labor Party which is free from the taint of some of the things we've seen emerge in ICAC in New South Wales. That is why today I'm announcing federal intervention into the New South Wales branch of the Australian Labor Party. And I've corresponded with the General Secretary of the New South Wales branch to that effect and copied that correspondence to members of the National Executive of the Australian Labor Party. This is not a decision which has been taken lightly. It's been taken in full consultation with the Deputy Prime Minister. It's been taken in full consultation with other senior ministers of the government, the Treasurer, as well as the Leader and Deputy Leader in the Senate, and also the subject of conversation, discussion, and dialogue with the full Cabinet earlier this week. The last such intervention to the New South Wales branch was conducted more than 40 years ago, but this is not a usual occurrence. Like all Australians, I've been appalled by the allegations arising out of the New South Wales Independent Commission against Corruption. These allegations have also appalled the tens and thousands of genuine, hard-working Labor Party members right across New South Wales and right across Australia. I've met so many of these folks in the time that I've been elected office. Good, salt-of-the-earth people out there labouring year in, year out to get Labor governments and Labor members elected. And it's those folks who feel this as badly as any of us in terms of what's been put before the nation through the lens of ICAC. While these specific matters before ICAC are being dealt with through the appropriate legal channels, I feel as the national leader of the party to ensure that the party is reformed. As a party, we must stamp out a culture which has allowed this type of behaviour to take hold. And that is why I've written to the General Secretary today. These reforms include, number one, zero tolerance of corruption, calling on the New South Wales branch to impose new rules so that any person with a finding of corruption is immediately expelled from the party, and that anyone being investigated for improper conduct can be removed from the party. At present, the rules do not explicitly permit this, and this has been a problem for the New South Wales branch in recent times. Number two, there will be a ban on property developers as candidates, instructing the New South Wales branch to impose a ban on property developers from standing as Labor Party candidates in the future. Number three, establishing independent judicial oversight to restore confidence in the dispute mechanism processes of the New South Wales branch. And so I've asked the New South Wales branch to dissolve the Disputes and Credentials Committee, which has been too controlled by factions, and establish a new New South Wales internal appeals tribunal. This tribunal will be chaired by a retired judicial officer or senior legal professional and comprised of individuals of utmost integrity who must not be actively seeking elected public office. Furthermore, I have written requesting the establishment of a Labor Ombudsman so that rank and file members of the Australian Labor Party can have their complaints heard and properly investigated in timely fashion by an independent and trusted person and authority. Finally, I've written to ask that we have an assurance in the future of at least 50% of the Administrative Committee of the New South Wales branch, the major decision-making body of the New South Wales branch, being made up of rank and file members, as well as containing three independent directors with board experience. Also, the establishment of a Charter of Rights and Responsibilities, making a clear statement that the rules are binding on all members. I regard this as a necessary set of reforms. I also reserve to myself the right to make a further request in the future should further reforms be necessary in the light of any subsequent findings by ICAC. I would like to acknowledge the role so far of John Robertson and what he has put forward in terms of early reforms to the rules which govern the parliamentary party in New South Wales. I'd also acknowledge the initial reforms undertaken also by the General Secretary, Sam Dastyari. This is the beginning of the reform program, and I will have asked the National Executive through George Wright, the National Secretary, to report back within 30 days on the implementation of this federal intervention. As I said before, I also reserve to myself the right to request further reform measures should they prove to be necessary. The time has come to modernise the Australian Labor Party. We need to open the windows and the doors of the great Australian Labor Party to the Australian community. We need to give people full voice, fair opportunity. We want, of course, continued full participation from members of our great Australian trade unions. We must also recognise there is a broader church in Australia who must be represented within the Australian Labor movement as well. And of course, therefore, the task of wider reform of the Australian Labor Party beyond New South Wales lies ahead of us, and I'll have more to say on that in the future.